The Philippine Health Department is leading an emergency meeting with immigration and airport authorities to tackle measures to contain the Wuhan coronavirus. And we now have on the line Philippine Health Secretary Francisco Duque. Mr. Secretary, it's going to be a busy day for you if it hasn't started already, but thanks for taking our call and welcome to the program.
Well, thank you. Good noon to you and to all your viewers, Carmina.
All right, so let's take it from where the press con yesterday left off. What's the latest on the sample sent to Australia from the five-year-old who's confined in Cebu?
Well, it's up for a confirmatory testing by the Victorian Infectious Disease Research Laboratory as per the recommendation of the WHO. That's where we sent the test sample for confirmation. And according to them, it will take about 24 hours from the time they officially receive the test sample.
So they haven't received it yet, or have they?
It's on the way because it was sent late afternoon yesterday by the courier, DHL.
Uh-huh. All right. So how is the patient doing, the patient in Cebu? How is he doing as we speak?
Well, the patient is no longer feverish very less coughing, and so this is a good sign of recovery. But what really puzzles us is the fact that the mother did not seem to develop any symptoms whatsoever. But just the same, the mother is also isolated, and throat swab was done, and blood samples were taken and sent to the RITM.
All right.
So the Research Institute for Tropical Medicine is the institute or the hospital where the initial testing is done.
Yesterday, though, it was also said during that press conference that contact tracing is already being conducted because he flew in from a flight, via flight from China. How is that contact tracing coming along, Mr. Secretary?
Well, that's in accordance with the established protocols. And what usually happens very briefly is that they take the flight manifesto of the plane that brought this particular passenger.
Yeah.
And then they identify the four persons in front, the four persons behind, the four persons to the left and to the right of this passenger. And then they took hold of the addresses of this, and the contact tracing is to be commenced. But I'm not sure whether that has commenced yesterday, because we needed to get a confirmation initially. But what is important is the Epidemiology Bureau of the DOH, together with the Bureau of Quarantine, already know exactly what to do.
So
in terms of contact tracing.
So you still can't give us any categorical answer as if there have been any other infections stemming from that patient in Cebu?
No, there is none as of now. The other three in Calibo, Aklan, I think you've heard about it as
yes.
well, have been found to not fit the case definition as prescribed for by the WHO in the interim guidelines for the novel coronavirus. So they were sent home, but not without getting a throat swab and blood specimens for the testing.
Is there any, I don't know what term you should use for it, but this is there any defining characteristic already of this new coronavirus in terms of incubation and prior to the manifestation of all these symptoms, Mr. Secretary? What do we know at this point?
What we know is that the clinical manifestations approximate that of the SARS or MERS-CoV in the very serious cases, and especially the elderly with underlying medical conditions or pre-existing illnesses, like the one that was reported in Wuhan, that the first person was actually a cancer patient. And understandably, this is the most vulnerable population, the elderly population, because of the lingering illness, one of which is cancer, then you have diabetes, and then hypertension, cardiovascular diseases, and they render the patient vulnerable to all sorts of infections that may be caused by viruses or by bacteria. Mm. And what normally wouldn't cause us problems, you and I, because we don't have underlying medical problems, would certainly be could be fatal to those with pre-existing or co-existing medical conditions. Mm.
The latest on this, Mr. Secretary, reaching us here in the newsroom, is that Chinese authorities are now saying that the virus is adapting and mutating. What is concerning about that?
Well, the fact that it is mutating, the fact that there seems to be now a growing evidence of a human-to-human transmission can certainly be alarming. But like most coronaviruses, some of which, at least four strains, save for MERS-CoV and SARS-CoV, all the other coronaviruses would be the cause of the common cold, one of the causes of the common cold you and I experience. Mm. So the mode of transmission is basically the same. Mm. Aerial droplets, you know, by sneezing, coughing. And so the personal hygiene has to be observed strictly, cough etiquette to boot, and avoidance of crowded places. And if when you suspect, of course, this is more the work of the Bureau of Quarantine, that I have to deeply investigate all these persons who may be suspects, no? For harboring the novel coronavirus. Mm-hmm. But for today, that's about all that we can tell you. What is important is the confirmatory test.
Right.
And we see what happens from there.
Mr. Secretary, Mr. Secretary, Australia, it has implemented stricter border controls to help prevent the spread of the new coronavirus. You're going to be meeting with airport and airline officials today. What will be your recommendations to them?
Well, they're covered under our protocols and guidelines, which the Bureau of Quarantine implements. And so it's the same for everyone. But the Bureau of Quarantine officers will don personal protective equipment, I think, beginning today. Mm-hmm. So that means they will be having their N95 masks and outfits that will help them prevent being infected. So these are all a part of the protocols that will automatically be implemented by the Bureau of Quarantine.
Good that you mentioned that, because yesterday we were talking to the health officer in Calibo, and he did say that they are lacking the personal protective equipment. So there's shipment coming in, considering that, you know, I think there's a flight that flies in directly from Wuhan into Aklan.
Well, let me check on that. But this is, I think, a provincial hospital. But let me just double check whether this is a national government hospital that is managed by mm-hmm. the DOH. Mm. Because if it is managed by the DOH, I am surprised to hear of that report, because we have ensured that always the hospitals must be in possession of adequate protective personal equipment, such as masks and the overalls, the outfits that will help prevent the virus from infecting or contaminating such quarantine officers.
Mr. Secretary, do we know how many flights come in per day from China, whether it's directly from Wuhan or have Wuhan as its point of origin? Do we have that? Do we have those numbers?
I don't have that information, although one thing I can say is that there is no direct flight from Wuhan City to any of our international gateways. But I really have no idea. I can ask the agency would probably be the DOT, the Department of Transportation might have that data you're asking.
Okay. Now, are you going to have to augment your funds? Do you have everything that you need, funds or otherwise, to face this threat, Mr. Secretary?
So far, we have adequate supplies of personal protective equipment, and the support coming from the national government is so far adequate. But the dilemma here is that we're also pouring our efforts towards mitigating the Taal volcano eruption that has affected thousands of families who are now in these evacuation centers. And we're also monitoring the health conditions there. And today, rather as of yesterday, there have been about 3,773 deported illnesses for which consultations were made.
Okay.
So topping that list would be the upper respiratory tract infection, the influenza-like illness, the diarrhea, the hypertension, and the eye irritation. So far, these are the five top conditions for which evacuees were consulting.
And finally, Mr. Secretary, yesterday in your press conference, you did say that you don't see any travel restrictions happening. Are you going to change this statement now, considering that coming from the WHO today, word reaching us here in the newsroom is that the WHO is advising against traveling at this time?
Can you say that again? Advising traveling?
Advises against traveling at this time. That's coming from the WHO.
Yes, that is my first time to hear about it. But let me tell you that I am in constant communication with the WHO country representative, Dr. Rabi Abiyasinha. And I will get in touch with him as soon as I put this phone down and ask him what changes have happened so far from the last press con that we had yesterday. But I'm sure that the advisory should be forthcoming, and we will make the necessary adjustments and abide by whatever new policies and guidelines are to be promulgated by the WHO.
Health Secretary Francisco Duque, thank you for taking our call. Thanks for talking to us this noon. Good luck to you and the rest of the team.
Camino.
Thanks again.